people, welcome back to another episode of our movie preview and review. Welcome back. It's a happy new year from us here at Remister Media to you all. It's your favorite girl B. Come along with me, guys.
All this integrity for money. I am not my predecessor. Mombra Shipnissel. This vessel is under arrest until you provide receipts for the cargo you're transporting.
The movie Blood Vessel was released on Netflix on the 8th of December 2023. This film follows the story of six people fleeing an oil-polluted community. They end up as stowaways on a ship, not realizing the dangers ahead, and now they must fight for their lives. We asked and Play Network listened. Let me start by saying this. After living in bondage, breaking free, this is Play Network's finest production. In past review of their films, I know I asked for movies with better stories, less fluff, more depth and coherent storytelling. And I must admit that they really tried to do that with this movie. What I liked about this movie, the movie started well with a solid storyline, decent cinematography and well-crafted set pieces. Let's not forget that they used an actual ship. It was really good to see the cast of this movie wave through their weight on the ship. In recent years, the people of Niger Delta in Nigeria have witnessed increasing environmental concerns that continue to threaten the health and livelihood of the people in that area. It's important that we talk about these issues, and I like the fact that this movie made an attempt to create awareness about this. Plot progression was coherent, casting was okay, acting was not bad, even the white guys were not so bad. Character development was thin, but still they gave us something and I'm thankful for that. Suspense, yes, there was a bit of it. The moment the six of them got on the ship, I was invested. I wanted to know what would happen next. I wanted to know how and when they would be discovered. I must also mention that the fights, the shooting and killings were quite believable and nicely executed. What I didn't like about this movie, I was bored. Despite the movie's attempt at the chilling thriller with all the required elements, killings, blood and tears, it was surprisingly unexciting. I couldn't wait for it to come to an end, and unfortunately, the boredom is palpable even in this review. Where did they really lose me? I think it was at the moment the stowaways were discovered and accused of being spies, and I was wondering, spies for who? This was the major plot point, but it did not make sense to me because there was no context as to why he would think them to be spies. The way Debe was suddenly killed, the skinning of Buma, the fight between the brothers, all this should have helped the movie, but everything was just underwhelming. It was devoid of chills, thrills and excitement. Even though I mentioned earlier that acting was not bad and casting was okay, all through the 119 minutes of this film, I couldn't help but feel this movie could have been so much more if it had had outstanding performances and a more compelling central character or hero. This might be an unpopular opinion, but Abby as a lead in this film was a no for me. I want to categorically state that I do not think that David Ezekiel Abby is a bad actor, but he just did not work as a lead for this film, and the performance was forgettable and unremarkable. The romance between Oyin and Abby was another big no. No chemistry, no connection. Even when they looked into each other's eyes, there was nothing there. The moments they shared should have been shining and moving moments in the midst of all the chaos, but it was just there. It was not sad enough to be poignant, and it was not sweet enough to be endearing. Also, even though I like the fact that this movie is premised on the environmental crisis in the Niger Delta region, it felt like it was more of a prop than an intentional attempt to explore that theme, because they did not say anything insightful about this topic they explored. What should have been an eye-opening perspective on the experiences of these people was used as a mere plot point to move the story forward. At the end of this movie, nothing about this issue stays with you. While watching the film, I had questions. Why was Pere in this film? Even though it wasn't clear when exactly he was locked up, weird that we did not see him witness any of the killings. If Pere was the captain of the ship, who was steering the ship after he was tied up? Also, where were the other members of the ship's crew? They all disappeared suddenly, and the only people we saw on that whole ship apart from the six stowaways were the four white people. What eventually happened to all the stolen crude oil? Tekena was thrown into the ocean in the middle of nowhere with a gunshot wound to his knee. How did he get home before Abby? Did he swim all the way from Cape Verde to Nigeria hanging on a log of wood? What was even more ridiculous was the fact that after the ordeal, he was not even sick or anything. His leg had been amputated and he had already healed before Abby, that was traveling on a ship, got home. Overall, Blood Movie might have its shortcoming, but it cannot be called a bad movie. It is a major improvement from the Play Network, and I am hoping to see more of this from them in the future. I'll be rating this movie a 4 out of 10 because there was nothing quite outstanding for me throughout this whole movie. At some point, it was very, very boring. Have you guys seen the movie? If you're yet to see it, go watch it, come back and let me know what you think. But if you've seen it, let me know what you think also in the comment section. And please don't forget to like, share and comment. And also follow us on all of our social media handles. On Instagram, we go by e.com_official. For Facebook and YouTube, we go by e.com_official. And for Twitter, we go by edotcom01. All in lowercase alphabets, no space in between. I remain your favorite girl, B. Bye, guys.